my channel, it's Cerise here, and today's video I have a ColourPop concealer video for you guys. So this retails for $9 and it is the Pretty Fresh Hyaluronic Creamy Concealer in shade Light. Now I got this a wee while ago. It is currently sold out at the moment and I've just had it sitting in my drawer and I was like, I need to crack this open. Let's do a video. Let's do it for you guys. So it is dermatologist tested, oil-free, gluten-free, paraben-free, and ideal for all skin types. So I have kind of like a normal kind of skin. And then in it you get 6.5 grams, and because it retails for $9, it's a freaking cheap-ass deal. So yeah, it says on here, hyaluronic creamy concealer, a long-wearing, full-coverage creamy concealer infused with hydrating ingredients for a natural, fresh finish. So I have done my foundation base, so I'm excited to put this on, see how it looks like on top. So it says, directions, prep under eyes with favorite eye cream, apply concealer to cover blemishes and even out skin tone, and blend using fingertips, beauty sponge, or brush. So I'm going to be using a beauty sponge today because I freaking love this little diamond one, and yes, it is a little bit dirty because I'm a grubby bitch. Sorry! So this is the packaging here, and it's really cute, nice and simple, just a nice kind of cute beige color, really nice and practical. I think it's really cute as well. And let's open her up. Oh, this is a really cute component. This almost looks like a mini foundation. It actually looks like a lot of product as well. I do like how the like glass bit is distributed with that bit. Like the composition of it is really cute. Makes it look like you've got more than probably what you have got. But yeah, let's open it up and see. Oh, so this is what the little thing looks like. This is like the other concealer's doe foots as well. It's a really cool doe foot. It's nice and bendable as well. And yeah, it doesn't have an overly strong smell or anything like that. And looking at the color, it's pretty dark. Like this says it's shade Light, but looking at it, it actually looks like it's gonna be quite, it just kind of looks like my skin tone, I guess. But yeah, I guess I'm just gonna put this on and we'll see how it blends out and do it in real time, how it goes. But yeah, it just looks very dark on the applicator. And if I leave it for a little bit, I'm just gonna leave it and see if it oxidizes at all. It just honestly looks like the same shade as my foundation. So yeah, I'm like, what one did it say on the box? Light 60N. So it's light 60N, so it's a shade of Light. So yeah, it's kind of got, this one's kind of got like, it almost looks like it's kind of got a pinky undertone to it. Do you kind of see that? But maybe it's just the trick of my eyes. I don't know. What do you guys reckon? I'm not sure. Let's see how it blends out anyway. We'll see how that goes. And I'm just gonna start blending it in. So I feel like it definitely has a pinky undertone to this one. So the 60N looks like it definitely has a pinky undertone. I do have like kind of, not really a rosy complexion, just kind of rosy cheeks. But I normally put blush on anyway, so it doesn't really bother me. But I am quite olive skinned, so it'll be interesting to see how this goes. This color on me, I feel like, is not a brightening color. I need to get more of the yellow toned ones for it to be more brightening. But this one's good because it kind of just works as just extra full coverage, which I am finding it's just really kind of covering up what I've covered. Like you guys seeing how I had that wee scab there, it's like covered, it's gone. She's gone, honey, she's gone. So as for the creaminess of it, it has, like, it's blended really perfectly in. It definitely has a pinky undertone. I can kind of tell under my eyebrow it's a little bit pinker. But it definitely has concealed everything. It hasn't brightened though. I feel like I need a lighter shade to do that. But it's definitely blended in and covered my blemishes. So that's the main thing. So I think what I've got to do now is just cover my whole face with everything else and see how it goes with all my normal face kind of on. Like with powder and everything on top. See if that affects it. But at the moment, like, it's blended quite nicely. It's not sticky. And it's covered my blemishes, which is what I wanted. So yeah, it's done everything that I wanted it to so far, but I definitely think that the color is maybe a little bit too on the nose for me, which is fine because the concealer is definitely concealing what I want, but I normally like using them as brightening shades, but it's definitely doing exactly what a concealer is doing. So I'm very impressed. And I kind of like that it's pretty much my skin tone, because I'm like, I could just put that on with no foundation underneath and see how that goes. So yeah, I'm gonna put on the rest of my face now and I'll be right back. Ta-da! So I have my whole face done now, and the concealer, like, looking at it, it definitely has blended in nicely how I would normally have it. It's covered up my blemishes and it feels nice, hasn't creased at all. I think for the price point of how much it is, you literally can't go wrong. It's a cheap, affordable, but that doesn't mean that it's horrible. Like, cheap and affordable can still be really good. So yeah, I honestly really think that this is a good deal, and that anyone that's been waiting to try it, try it. But definitely, like, think about for the color what you want to use it for, because I'd like to use them normally for brightening, but this one is just going to be to cover up shit. So yeah, so for, you know, what it isn't a really amazing concealer that does what it's meant to do. So let me know in the comments down below if you've tried this concealer before, and if you have, let me know. But until next time, I love you guys so much and I'll see you on the next one.